A, we are going to mark a queen bee. Most of the tips and tricks that I know about marking queen bees come from Allan Beil. Allan Beil is one of Australia's more experienced stingless beekeepers, and he's responsible in a large way for giving a lot of the information that has helped to write scientific articles on lifespans of queens, queen behaviour, things like that. Allan actually puts he sucks up the queen in an aspirator. He puts the queen in the aspirator in a freezer for a little while, and this just cools the queen down. Then once the queen's cooled down, it enables him to be able to put an accurate spot on her without running away. I like to do something a little bit different, so we'll show you that today.
So this is the apparatus we'll be using today. This is just one I made up. It's called a pooter or aspirator, and it's for collection of insects. I've used just a bit of cheesecloth stretched really tight to seal the pipe that I'll be sucking on, because I don't want bees in my mouth. And that's the control end. Inside here there's just a bit of soft foam. This is just mattress foam I've put in there, and it just cushions the bee as you suck her up. Now when you suck the queen bee up, you want to suck her from head first. She doesn't always go in that way, but just her head hitting the sponge first will be much better on her body than abdomen first. You can crush her abdomen if you do it that way.
Now finding your queen bee can be quite troublesome and frustrating sometimes. So if you haven't found your queen bee in the first 5 minutes, I would recommend closing the hive up and trying again the next day. The queen will come up sometimes, like this one did, but it doesn't happen all the time. Oh, you would say
that oh, I could run, but no.
Okay, so we've got our queen in here, inside our jar. You can see her walking around in there. I don't know if you can see that, but what I'm going to do now is I'm going to put her in this. It's basically a mini, honeybee keepers have these for marking their queens. I made a mini one with chenille fabric and a bit of foam on a little plunger. So I'm going to put her in there, and this is just going to enable me to gently press her against that thing so that she's still and I can get the spot exactly where I want it. I don't want to get her on the face or the abdomen. The only safe place is on the back of the thorax, and paint. I'm going to be using a Posca paint marker for this, and you want to make sure that paint has gone off before you put her back in the hive. So let's just have a look where she is and transfer into here. Now, if she's a mated queen, she shouldn't be able to fly away. Just gonna wait till she's on the plunger. Okay, so gently just pressed her there. Now with your paint marker, you don't want it going everywhere, so you just, to start it, you push it on your thumbnail, and you don't want too much on it. You only want to put a tiny little dot on her. Okay, so I don't know if you can see that, but that's a really little dot put on her. Just might get my other lens now and we'll do a close-up of her. Okay, here we have the queen. It's a nice close-up, so you can have a look in there. Oops. There she is. You can see the little dot. You want to make sure that when you put her back in the colony, that it's done really gently. I'll show you how to do that. Putting bees into colonies straight away and throwing them in can trigger bees to grab a hold of other bees and kill them. And you don't want that, so we'll go do that now.
Basically, I just gently put her back in on the brood or drop her in like that. But yeah, generally just putting her back on the brood is the best way to go. Just gently.